Younger president, that bitch is finally out. And it doesn't matter how much he complains or whines or pouts. His company is tanking and his friends have all left him. And there's about an 80% chance that he'll end up in prison. These past 4 years have been shitty for us all, but especially if you're black, gay, brown, Muslim, female, or had any kind of disability. And to all the Trump supporters that just fucking kissed his ass, how does it feel to love someone that doesn't give a shit about you back? Cause while you were storming the Capitol yelling Trump 2020, Trump was asking why his supporters look so poor and disgusting. So we can all take a fucking breath and know that from now on, America will not be led by an orange Donkey Kong. Sorry for cussing, I'm really fucking not. And if your bitch ass doesn't like it, then get the fuck off my TikTok. Cussing helps me get through every shitty goddamn day. So fuck shit, damn bitch, asshell twat is what I love to say. If I offend you with my language, here's what you fucking do. Unfollow or block me, cause I'm not fucking living to please you. If you report this video, I wish you the best of luck. But before I go, I want you to know that fuckity fuck fuck fuck. I fucking hate religion, I really, really do. And if you know a religious person, then you hate that shit too. Before you crucify me or start crying about this song, please shut your mouth and hear me out because I want us to get along. You have the fucking right to practice whatever you believe, but we have a problem when you fucking push that shit on me. I don't care if you pray to God or sacrifice a goat, but I don't want your weird cultist bullshit shoved down my damn throat. I'm not worried about eternity or if I will go to hell. I'm just trying to watch Netflix, have sex, go to work, and pay my bills. Fucking matter, they really fucking do. And if you respond with all lives matter, then this song is for you. If you just take a goddamn second and open up your eyes, you'd see the fucked up injustice that's been done to black lives. We know that all lives matter, that's just fucking common sense, but we gotta stop ignoring minority systemic racism. Imagine going certain places and getting racist glares just because your skin color's fucking darker than theirs. Don't ignorantly say that rioters speak for BLM. You might as well say jihadist terrorists represent Islam. They don't. We're goddamn people that just want equal treatment and dignity. We're all beautiful, but ignorance will make you butt ass ugly. Hate people, I really, really do. And if you work in a grocery store, then you hate people too. I swear shoppers get dumber when they walk through those front doors. They ask you stupid questions as they zombie through the store. And God forbid we're out of the shit that they came in to buy. I guess it's my motherfucking fault that we're out of apple pies. The customer's always right is a fucked up steaming pile of lies. We can't say shit to care when they bitch about the price. So please be kind to us because we're fucking serving you. We don't get paid enough to put up with your bullshit too. Fucking stand in support of LGBTQ. And if you don't accept people for who they are, then fucking shame on you. And if you give me that bullshit that the Bible says it's wrong, you should know that book promotes more murder than the Holocaust. Let's put your homophobia aside for a quick second. How the fuck does it affect your life if someone's bi, gay, or lesbian? It doesn't. People are goddamn people, and love is fucking love. How are we so goddamn close-minded in fucking 2021? So whether you're gay, bi, trans, pan, asexual, or you're not sure, be proud, be free, and don't let shitty people keep you hidden behind closed doors. So buckle the fuck up, cause America's getting more diverse. Quit looking for reasons to hate other people and start looking at your own ignorance first. Hate my exes, I really, really do. And if you have loved a douchebag, then you hate your ex too. I was stupid and I got lured in by their fucking lies. Now if I see that SOB, I'll slash their goddamn tires. They cheated on me with an ugly Shrekish looking troll. I hope they can fucking handle all the mind games and control. I really have moved on from that god awful piece of shit. And now that I'm without that person, my life is fucking lit. Social media thoughts, I really, really do. And if you shake your ass for likes, then you might be one of those hosts too. These daddy issue divas always flex like they're happy. But half these bitches have six kids and are struggling on EBT. They need that validation that their followers give them. Even though most of these people are perverted, creepy men. And before you bitch about this song, please know that I'm a feminist. But there's a difference between being sexy and being a clout-chasing thirsty bitch.